what's happening, crew? Tuesday afternoon here in the Ville. We're about to roll out. We got the rigs set up on the Velocio rack. I got two bottles here. Take a guess at what's in these bottles. The mama bear's coming home. If you said Element, you were right. So Element sponsoring this video. And everybody should be thankful for two things. First, if you click the link down below, you'll get this sample pack. They have a few different options, but you'll get this for the price of shipping. So that's the first reason you should be excited. Second reason is, what we're gonna do today is we're gonna go preview a new spot. So they're building like crazy and it's hard to keep up with all these spots. So excited Element's gonna allow us to do that. There's a couple things you need to think about. The hydration piece, I've talked about it over and over again, but we're transitioning from winter into spring. So the temperatures are gonna be coming up a little bit. And I think in winter, most people, they're not on top of their hydration like they should be. They're still drinking water. A lot of people made these New Year's resolutions, but you gotta think about what's not in water. And what's not in water is sodium, potassium, magnesium, okay? Your sweat doesn't taste like water. So it's very important to replace those things. And now with the weather getting better, you're probably gonna get out and ride more, which means you need to be better hydrated. So one of the things I like about this is I have my canteen, I fill it up, I wake up in the morning, I grab it, I start drinking. This allows me to stay a little bit more on top of my hydration before I go out and ride. So when we go out and ride, we're filming, we're doing clinics, things get busy, it's hard to remember to drink. So if I get it taken care of in advance, I'm in a little bit better position. Now, another thing too, when you're mixing, you can lean it out as much as you want. So it says mix anywhere from 16 to 32 ounces. You can go even a little bit more. I like to go about 42 ounces with mine. So you decide whatever you want. So we're gonna roll out not too far from downtown Bentonville, mountain bike capital of the world. We're gonna go see a spot called Apple Dumplin. You ready? So we come. We park down here. This is, they call it the Tiger Cub lot. So Northeast A, Cub loops around real quick, and then there's Tiger Boulevard. So just to kind of orient you, if you're not familiar, straight back that way or straight south is downtown. So downtown's not far at all. This is a smaller parking lot. So if you can't park here, you can go down Northeast A, there's another spot there, or you can go back up towards downtown and there's another parking lot there. So it's quieted down. There's construction equipment everywhere around here. They're building furiously. So we're gonna go over to this Black Apple Zone is what I'm calling it. I think it's Slaughter Pen Phase 2. I honestly don't know. We're gonna show you a specific trail called Apple Dumplin. So I rode it. I did a Friday trail check on it way back when, and they've completely redone it. It looks rad. And Woody from Progressive Trail Design, one of the OG builders around here, shot me a message, said, hey man, go check it out. I wanna see what you think. So we're gonna roll over and check the flow on the Izzo. Yo, yo, you know? Time to go. So rolled into this whole Black Apple section. There it is right there. You see the do not enter. So they've now changed this. It used to be two-way with the left side. Apple Dumplin is where the downhill was. So now you can see with the signs there, it's very specific about this being one way. So I don't even know where to go from here. So we're going to try to hit this one behind me and see if it takes us where we need to go, I think. So there's a culvert, a drainage pipe. They're probably making some adjustments, but here's a look. So from where we're sitting, you can see it comes down on a decent slope. So since they're working here, what we're gonna do We'll roll in at the top and we'll check it out here. So we'll head up now, we'll walk it a little bit, give you a little visual of what we're talking about. But from where we're standing, it looks pretty fun. Flowy, smooth, decent takeoff right here. Like, I'm expecting this is gonna be a couple really fun tabletops. So let's roll up, check it all out. Yeah, dude. Step down. Yeah, I can see from here how you could get ripping. Still think a triple here is possible. Dude, look at this. Just looks so rad from down there. So we're up a little bit closer to the top. I like what I'm seeing. Bunch of really cool step ups. Takeoffs are shorter, but they don't look like they build too much. So I think this is gonna be fun for a lot of people. So Mason, I say we roll into it, dude. Let's give it a run, see what we're dealing with. Pretty fun. Just another rad trail in the long list of trails that you're gonna hit when you come visit Bentonville and bike Bentonville. I'm excited for this one, should be open soon. This whole zone, really cool, fun, flowy jump lines. You got some technical stuff over there. Great for almost the entire family. Really easy ride from downtown, maybe 3/4 of a mile at the most. So I'm excited. We're gonna go check out some other stuff. Maybe cruise back downtown, grab a coffee. So let me know if you have any questions on this. Keep your eyes peeled for another more in-depth overview on this one when it's done. We might drop a little how-to on how to tackle Apple Dumplin. Don't forget, click below, hit that link, get yourself a free sample pack of Element just for the cost of shipping. Have a great day, be positive out there. Peace out, dumpers.